editing to the music. No joke, I actually look like that when I'm editing. Seriously.
What's up, tubulars? Welcome to a series of how-to videos that my business partner Maria and I are putting together. And this kind of jump starts from her video where she talks about organizing footage. And on this particular video, I want to talk about how editing to music is so important. From a beginner aspect here, and I'm still a beginner, and I'm sure many of you are beginners out there, editing to music, the sound design, is extremely important because ultimately the music itself kind of helps tell that narrative. So I've got a few tips here, and one of the tips is really how that music is going to help you tell that narrative. It's so important to try to find music that helps you thread the story. Now, whether you're a vlogger like myself or doing commercial work like I do as well, you want the viewer to experience something that not only is the storytelling through the visual aspect of the video, but also the sound, the audio. How does it help thread the story? Now, if you're picking music that doesn't necessarily fit the tone of the story, it doesn't really go along with what in the world is going on, then you're gonna lose that viewer. You're gonna lose that connection. So storytelling is paramount when it comes to vlogging or commercial work, weddings, like whatever you're doing, the story is the biggest piece. And the music is going to help tie that all together. So that is definitely my first and most important tip, is picking music that's appropriate. Now for me, I will typically go in and try to find music first, oftentimes, especially on a commercial project. If I've met with the client and I kind of get an idea of what we're going to be shooting that day or several days, I will actually go and find music that I think is going to fit my shooting style even before I go in. So that's my pre-production. I will go try to find that music. For vlogging, it's not always like that, but when I go to Epidemic Sound, I can create these folders for inspiration because I have all these ideas when I'm vlogging, and you probably do too. So in these folders, I have music that's saved that inspires me to, let's say, tell that story that I've been meaning to tell or share that piece of my life that I've been meaning to share, and I feel like that's the piece of music that fits. But why don't we actually cut over to Marie and I while we're talking about it, and we're discussing how I usually pick my music first, but I want to give you at least her insight and her experience on how she actually goes and picks the music, because she doesn't often pick it first.
I never find the music before I vlog, ever.
Okay.
Like, I have a few things saved on Epidemic, like in my own playlist, but mm-hmm. I take my inspiration usually from the footage itself. I will go on Epidemic and I will just go to like top albums right now and start listening to stuff. And like any genre from like, last night I was listening to like modern symphonic or some genre that I've never even like heard of.
Okay.
Okay, like R&B, 2010s pop, like 80s pop, instrumental, ambient covers like a wide range of like...
Wow.
You things that are labeled as ambient cover like a lot of genres.
Okay.
So yeah, I mean, I just start like casting a wide net, and then I will usually find like an element of something that I like, and I'll kind of try to find similar until I find the one.
All right, so now we've got our music picked out, and the next tip really is the basic music theory. Folks, it's basic music theory. I don't want to get flamed by anybody, you know, the experts out there. I actually read music, I've studied music, I have played instruments, so I understand. But what I want to do is get into the basics of the four beats in a measure. And that's typically where you have that 1, 2, 3, 4, one. And I want to talk about that one here in just a second. So again, basic music theory is that you have those four beats in a measure. And when we talk about those beats, I'm going to open up Final Cut Pro and I'll show you those markers where you can put those in to help you with transition, because oftentimes on those beats, you may want to actually transition the shot. So in this particular shot, we're not talking about just a 4-beat measure here. We're talking about all of these beats that essentially just flash really fast. And I think that's actually kind of a pro tip, where most people think like, oh my gosh, you don't have but like half a second or just a blink to see that particular clip, but can actually add some kind of cinematic flow to it to still tell the story. Like, there's a lot happening there. In here in Final Cut, you'll actually see that I have to expand my timeline here, open that up a little bit so I can get those markers. So why don't we dive into that?
All right, so as you can see, I've opened up Final Cut Pro here and I've highlighted a clip. And the reason why I wanted to show you that is that when you right click that, what you want to do is actually separate your audio. So you want to detach the audio, which I've already done, but I've detached this audio and deleted it because I didn't want any of the ambient noise or the voiceover or anything like that. I didn't want any environmental noise because I'm working with a music track here. So anytime that you're recording with audio inside of the camera itself, I still recommend detaching that audio so you can work with it separately, even if it's just a vocal track. But right now we just have this music track. So I always recommend also trying to expand that so that you can actually look and see these peaks here. So when I was talking about that 4 beats per measure, these are some beats, like some claps or some drops that essentially I might want to transition on. So what you would do is, so I see this is kind of a repeat. So if I do Command and plus, like I can really expand that out. So I see what this looks like, and I see this looks very familiar. It's very much the same, so on and so forth. All right, but I want to shrink that down. So Command and then minus. Now I highlight the audio track, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to play it, and then I'm going to mark it with an M on those beats. Okay, so the mark may not necessarily be perfect, but that's where you can actually take your footage and actually work with it a little bit, so that if you're working on a transition, you can kind of move this stuff around, of course, the way that's actually attached. But like if I wanted to transition here on this beat and I wanted it to come down on that particular beat, then it would. So essentially that M, very simple, you just mark where those clicks are, those drops or claps or whatever, so you can transition. But what I wanted to actually show you is something I think a little bit more cinematic and maybe a little bit more complicated, but I think it'll give your video a little bit of pop. All right, so don't necessarily pay too much attention to the footage just yet, but I want to talk about that rapid succession. And so like if we play it, you can hear that, where it's like going really, really fast. Now that might take a little bit of time to sort of get in sync with so that you're marking it. And I would again just expand that a little bit here. And let's listen to it again. Okay, so I've made these marks. And again, they may not necessarily be perfect, but it'll give me a place to work from. So I already have these clips cut. So what I want to actually do is I will drag this over here. And looks like I might need to actually get this over here. And that's the beauty about this in Final Cut, or you know, any video editor where you can just kind of drag the clip where you need it to transition very quickly. Okay, and you can make adjustments as you need to. If I need to bring that out a little bit on that drop. So these are pretty much lined up here. These markers are fairly, and like I said, you can, as you saw, you can kind of drag and move those around as they fit into that transition. So it's actually a pretty cool transition, I think. It's very quick, very visual to the point, like you're not focused on it for very long, rapid succession, but I think it actually gives it a pretty good look.
Okay, so seeing those markers, you kind of get a visual for it. The next thing is thinking about that one beat that I was talking to you about. So that drop, so that transition into something that could just go pop. So in this particular vlog that I'm about to show you, there was a build of the music where I was actually pulling away from my kids, and then the next transition, boom, like I cut right to something that I think was very powerful visually, and the music was actually helping me tell that story. And so there was a marker that I had put right there, and I had put all of the clips in place. Like I put that marker like where that drop happens and like where that opens up. That marker was extremely important to do that even before I had all of the frames laid out. So let's actually take a look at that.
So now we're actually on a scene that I was talking about where I had some marks that I wanted to make some great transitions on that I felt like it would help transition that clip. And then I had this zoom out point, and then it transitioned into something I thought was kind of more majestic, more powerful. So if we go in here, and that's the moment that I want to mark to transition into this particular clip. Right there. Highlight. Okay, so I marked it. And then essentially I'll drag that here. And see how that just, it transitioned right into that. And then I have this pullback. And then I have this clip here that I want to transition into. And I can see right here, this is actually where it's going to hit. You can see that peak. And if you mark it, and of course you can listen to it, but if you mark it, then if you need to manipulate this a little bit, move this around, see that mark is always there. Like if you needed to add something else, like another clip or whatever you want to do, at least you know that that's where the drop happens. So again, like if this were over here, and I know that's where the mark is, so I want to move that here. And then I've got that transition. So let's actually just watch that.
All right, so we've got some basic tips here, especially for the beginners out there, when it comes to putting your footage together and editing with music. Again, find something that inspires you to help tell the story, because we all want to be good storytellers, right? Because we all love hearing a great story and seeing that visual aspect of it. So don't be afraid to kind of get into the music a little bit, you know, and move around. I mean, I'm not kidding. Like, I will definitely move around while I'm editing. You certainly don't have to move around. It's not a requirement. It's just the energy that I have like while I'm editing. Hopefully you found this useful, and I hope that you can apply some of this when you're going out there shooting your vlogs, doing commercial work, how-to videos, reviews, whatever it is. Just be purposeful, be mindful, and intentional with your music to help tell that story. If you like this video, definitely be sure to hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, be sure to just get metal on that. I mean, seriously, get metal on that subscribe button. Stay tuned for what's to come here in the series and the vlogs. And as always, keep rocking faces, do things that matter. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we'll catch you on the next one.